Hello everyone, welcome to Brez Angels Creations. I hope you're having a wonderful night. And for all of you who have not been here before, this is Amy. Hi, how are ya? Hope you'll enjoy the video. And if you haven't hit that red button, make sure you do, as well as ring my little notification bell so you know when my next video is. Excuse me. So, that there is part of the reason why I haven't made very many videos this past week, because my voice decided it was going to play games with me just as I wanted to do a music video for you all. So that kind of really bummed me out. And I'm looking at it in the positive side. The positive side of things is it's giving me time to pick the song that I need to figure everything out and how I'm going to do it. So that's how I'm going to look at it. It's giving me some time to get things set up and situated. As well as I am a care provider for someone I love and care for very much. And this past week has been a little tiring and trying for me. So between my voice and that, I figured we do a little something small and something cute. So I shared my rides with you home from various different places. That's what I do. But here we go. And excuse my voice. As you can tell, it still just does not want to come back right. Okay, so I'm going to show you how to make this adorable little table. Isn't this super cute? It's almost like a little picnic table without the benches. And I'm going to show you how to do that. I used regular crafter sticks, the wooden ones, and then I stained it with this really nice cherry stain. So, what you're going to need is you're going to need 10 crafter sticks for your top. You're going to need 4 for the legs, and then you're going to need another 4 for your top hinges or braces. And then you're going to as well as need 1 access or 2 to make bottom braces on the legs on the table down across on the bottom. So what I like to do is take a piece of tape. After I line my sticks up, I'm going to make a little pattern. I got these colorful ones. You can find them pretty much anywhere in the craft section. And I'm just going to take the piece of tape after I line them up. I want them nice and even. You'll notice when I do a lot of these projects, having a square and a ruler is always great because they just help out so much. All right, like I said, so I'm going to take this piece of tape. And I'm going to make sure they're nice together. And hold them together like this. So that's going to help it so I put my braces on. And that's going to help hold these popsicle sticks into place, or craft sticks into place. So I'm just going to grab... Probably I have 2 more of the blue left, so I'm going to use them for my bottom braces. And what I like to do is on the original in the book that I have, it showed the popsicle stick hanging over the edge. But what I like to do is take my rotary tool and just even them out on both sides. Or you can mark them and then cut them before you put them on. But I like to just take my rotary tool after and just go across, make it nice and even. And I made a boo-boo, so I got to fix this. Oh my goodness. Okay, so now I am going to glue on my 2 braces. And I was wrong about what you're going to need. You're going to actually need 4 for braces. The two for after the legs are on to help the legs stay sturdy, plus these two original braces to hold the top together. And wood glue always is amazing, is probably always the best, but I have been to the hardware store a few times, and guess what? I keep forgetting that I need wood glue. So I'm using the hot glue gun. And as always, the hot glue gun is extremely hot, so be very careful. These bubble when they come out. I really love my little adorable hot glue, my glue gun. It's a super bonder, and I highly recommend them. And I just dropped it. So all errors, I'm not going to stop the camera. I'm just going to keep going. Just like I know that this is so late, I'm probably not going to do any fancy editing to the video, but what the heck, right? Alright, so now once I get my two little braces on, then what I'm going to do is take four more on each side. I'm just going to keep this here, and it'll help keep it in place while I'm working. Oh, what a wild night. I just don't know. I have a couple obnoxious friends, and if they're listening, they know who they are, and I'm not sorry, but you are just out of control. Yeah, that's all I'm getting at, and yeah, I love watching my friends because I love to party. I love to drink some, but not all too much. So I got carried away babbling on, and here we go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take two popsicle sticks and I'm going to stand them up on their side. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take two more for the legs and I'm going to glue them in between like this. Oh my goodness, you know what? So I didn't think this one through, did I? I didn't think this one through. All right, and I figured it out. There we go. So what I want to do before I glue it on is I'm going to glue these together. So I'm going to take, and you want to make sure they're even so your legs stand straight. And this is where the square comes in real well. So that way you can have your legs all the same. Or your grid mat, if you have a cutting mat, it has a nice measurements and cutting grid, that works too. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take both of these popsicle sticks. But right now, I need to know because I don't want them hanging over. So I'm going to go in this much, right? I probably should mark it with my pencil. You know what? I'm going to do this one the way they say, so why not? All right. I'm not being up all night. So you got one here, and then you're going to take your second one. And you're going to cross it. And like I said, this is definitely a good way place to use your square. That way you know your legs are going to be lined up evenly. And this happens. Look at this. This is funny. Are these even the same size? Okay, so yeah. See what I mean about the square, right? All mistakes here. This is the intentions. Laugh at me all you want. I am not going to stop. I am not going to edit. I am just going to make my mistakes and So I'm going to take my leg right to the corner. And that way I have it even on both sides. And I'm going to take my square and make sure I line it up on the corner of the bottom of the craft stick. And make it sure it's straight, of course. Now this is where it's going to get tricky. Remembering exactly where. So I think it's best that I keep my straight. I'm just going to take a dab of my glue. That's not my glue. I can't claim it. It's not my glue. All right, so there's one. And now I'm going to do the same on the other side. Once I get myself, organized. The same as I did on the other side. I'm just gonna leave this sitting here. That way I can put it down. There we go. What I'm going to want to do before I let this dry is really quickly put a dab down here. That way I can brace it in both spots. Okay, so if I did this right, and if you see, and it sure don't look right to me. There we go. So I got one side done. Oh goodness, I got glue everywhere. So here's one side finished, and I'm going to get the other side done. All right, now that I got the second one done, I'm going to take two more of the yellow popsicle craft sticks. They are popsicle sticks too, but let's keep it, I guess, like right technical, they say. So now I'm gonna take these two and I'm just gonna glue them here and right here. See that? Here's one, here's two. Yeah, that's gonna work. I wanna make sure they're lined up even because they're going to go sit in like this on the base. So, oh my goodness. Look at the glue fly. All right. And to do the same to the second one, I wanna make sure. Yeah, all right. There's one, there's two, probably a little bit too much glue. And I think I need another glue stick in. Yay. All right. So like I did with the other one, I want to make sure they're both flush, even, straight. And wow. Like, wow. Okay. So as you see, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to glue a line on both sides on the legs. These glue guns are amazing. Like I can literally take out just a tiny, I can squeeze the trigger just a very little bit and a tiny little bit will come out. if I get out of hand sometimes, more comes out. But really, look at that nice line of glucose on there. And I'm not overusing any. I have not had... This is a small glue gun, and usually you're constantly putting sticks in, especially with projects like this, but that stick that I was using was like almost over half gone, and I am almost done this table, and I'm still on that first stick, even though because I had to put the other one in, and... I'm just so happy. This isn't no, I'm not sure what you would say, promotion for them or anything. I just really want to share this with other crafters because I know how annoying it can be if we put too much glue on something, especially if we don't want to. We need just that little tiny bit of glue. And it really does, and it works out wonderful. So now I'm gonna untape it from my mat. And let's see if it stands right. And it does. Oh my god. Look at my table. Oh my goodness, what did I do? Oh, I see what I did. Yeah, I did, didn't I? That's funny. So this is what happens if you make silly mistakes like I did. I'm not exactly sure what's happening here. But, yeah, something's not right. I think I don't get it. I don't get it. But this is what I do. This is why I say grab your rotary tool. For these very reasons. Not just because I like to take the ends off, but when all else fails... I like to put a nice flat bottom. As you see, this is what I like to do, and I did this with this other one. Is I like to make a nice flat bottom. That way when you put your flower pots on, it's nice and even and flat. Okay, that took just a couple seconds, right? Kind of loud, and I'm still got to adjust. I know what I did. When I made my second, I did not use my square. And that's why... Let you in on a little secret. I did this on purpose to show the reason why using a square is so important, and especially for me, because if I don't use a square, this is exactly what happens. But it's okay because you can always salvage it by doing exactly what I'm doing right now. And I noticed my bead of glue came loose from here. Okay, so now I'm almost got this table right. Once I get it right, then I can put my braces on. And it looks just about almost right, and it is. Almost done. So that's good enough for tonight. Now, as you notice, this table is nice and beautiful. nice and even, stands nice and sturdy. I can really push down on this. And it's really good, but what I'm going to do, because I forgot to do it before, is I'm going to make a little brace. And I'm going to cut that, and I'm going to put that in between these two on the bottom here. And what that's going to do is help the legs be more sturdy. And that's the same with this. And what you just do is you cut your piece. Look at this. I really got to show you. This is hilarious, right? Oh my goodness. Ah, this is so funny. I hope people are rolling on their floor. I hope you are laughing your ass off, because this is hilarious. Look how far off these legs are. Like, they don't even line up at all in any shape, way, or form. This is why I say use a square, because I can't do it right without a square. This is what you get. Well, it's actually not that bad now. I got it right. See? So it's always salvageable. Even though it doesn't look exactly perfect or right, it really doesn't matter, especially if it's just a fun project to do. So, like I said, what you're going to do is you're going to take a piece and you're going to cut it down. And when your braces are right, like this one, it's going to sit like this on the inside. Which you can either do that, it's going to actually be straight, not like this, but it's going to be on the inside, and you're going to glue it so it's basically squeezing on your centerpiece. So here's this little adorable table I just made. Even though the legs don't look exactly the same way they cross, look at it. It's a nice little table. It stands up nicely. It has its cute little braces. This one's so colorful. And I can put the little flower pot right on top of it. That's kind of gross, right? Okay. I pulled it out from underneath the sink. I kind of took the flower out and put it under. So see how it's kind of a little wobbly? And that brace that you put in there will help that stop. So, and of course, if you don't have to bring it down so much, your table looks nice. But this is what it looks like when you take and sand down the sides of the craft stick so you don't have a rounded side on the outside. And that is how you make a super adorable little tiny picnic table-like situation. Isn't that cute? They're so adorable. And they're really cute for flower pots. Really, 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 really cute. So this is like, I think, the longest video I have ever made. And the reason for that is because I'm working on my phone. And I'm having fun. I really am. And I am doing this all for you. And I couldn't be more happy to meet the most wonderful people, I think, on the planet. Because every one of you that I've met, you have amazing talent, you're smart, you're special, and your energy is amazing. I love the smiles, I love the happy energy, and that's just, I'm in a lovable mood tonight. I think we had a little bit too much. But anyways, so that's like super adorable, screwed up little table, and it will look like this when they're right. Obviously, I was just playing around, having some fun, and it really did work. And this is what it gets, and this is so cute. Isn't that adorable? Look at the colors. Those braces actually stand out nice. And as you see, it sticks out on the side. I don't like that. I myself like to be able to have it fully covered on the side. And you know what? This one easily could take two more popsicle sticks. It would be 12 wide, but look at this. Two more. It could easily take two more. So if you need it a little bit wider, you could keep it on like that or do it that way. But, all right, I guess I'm babbling. I hope you all have a super fun weekend. And I got a Keeping It Real video coming. Breeze Angels Keeping It Real, definitely coming. The weather has kept me from having a campfire or fire, whatever that may be. It is a super bummer because it's been raining and raining and raining and gloomy and windy and gross. So, yeah, there will be a fire video very soon. My own or friends, who knows? So if it's a friend's, you're going to hear a lot of people. You're going to hear a lot of laughing. I'm just warning you now. You're going to hear some really, you know how it can be. So, hell hop. I hope you all have a wonderful night. I will see you soon. And remember, if you haven't hit that red button, make sure you do so you can see some more of my goofiness, more of my silly mistakes, and who knows what will come up next. But I know one thing, once this here comes back, because singing is impossible, I really would not want to sing right now. You would never think or ever believe that I could sing, because my voice would cut out, it would go gurgle, 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 who knows, right? So, I got some really fun videos coming, and I'm doing this all for you, and the best thing is, I know I can make some goofy smiles. I'm a goofy person, so I'll make some goofy smiles to make you laugh. I'll make some goofy smiles to make you smile beautifully, because you know what? The smiles are absolutely beautiful. Your smile makes you shine. And I think I gotta go. See you later.